Have you ever wondered how to utilize the power of AI for enhanced semantic search across a multitude of formats such as websites, PDFs, and structured data? In this video, we're diving into a service for exactly this, Google's Vertex AI Search. Ready to leap into the Google Cloud Console and start the journey? Our mission starts with a brand new project where we'll jump into the GenAI App Builder page. Go ahead and enable the API. The heart of GenAI App Builder is, unsurprisingly, the concept of apps. These are specific, tailored experiences which can assemble, enrich, and synthesize the data from your various data repositories. Today, our radar is locked onto one specific app option, Vertex AI Search. We'll use the website-based data option enabled by the Enterprise Edition features. This grants you other capabilities like using image data and verbatim extracted answers. In this tutorial, we'll run the public web content crawler against our softwaresim.com website. Reference the examples and use multiple configurations across multiple lines if necessary. Typically, you'll want wildcards so that you can survey vast sectors of your site. We'll get the gears turning by verifying the Software Sim website, adding this verification record in our preferred DNS provider. It usually only takes a few seconds, but sometimes you may need to wait a bit longer for the domain verification. Tracking the index status will reveal if Google Cloud has gathered all the data for your AI search engine. Feel free to peruse the other features as the index builds out. When it's time, we'll advance to the search page and input queries anchored in our website data. Your search findings will surface as a simple list, an AI-based abstract, or even multi-turn queries. We have settings for things like search safety. You can further explore the integration possibilities and can integrate this search into both internal and external applications and services. An API-based approach is also possible, and the curl template automatically fills out when you provide your query. You can easily test out these calls using something like the Cloud Shell. While indexing can sometimes take hours, it will eventually reach completion. A point to note is that we used softwaresim.com as our domain, and the system automatically added a subdomain wildcard. As a result, interestingly, we make a query like, "What is discrete event simulation?" It doesn't pull data from the proper softwaresim.com pages, but instead returns non-English content from translated websites and media pages, like a PDF white paper. we need to add another configuration to get non-subdomain data here. We must now wait for additional indexing before testing. Upon completion of indexing, Vertex AI Search will be able to leverage the additional data to answer questions. We have observed that the confidence threshold to provide a summarized answer is very high, so you often won't get a summarized generative AI answer if your dataset is relatively small. The AI responses are designed to be highly accurate and grounded in the queried data. You're not restricted to a single question. Follow-up queries like, when is it useful, can be asked. In which case, again, we don't get a summarized answer, but do get very relevant links and content snippets. We hope that this introduction has been helpful, and we look forward to any questions you might have in the comment section. As always, thank you for watching, and please enjoy responsibly.